الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الذين أظهر الله عنهم الرسى وطهرهم تطهيرا أوصيكم عباد الله ونفسي بتقوى الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. This week is the week of Ghadeer. We had the celebration last night. And I'd like to take this opportunity to talk about the overall theme that the Prophet of Islam presented in that largest gathering that he had in his life. In the preamble, he talks about his approaching death and then ends with the very important message of the succession in regard to the wilayat and imamat of Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wasalam. And in between, he talked about some of the important teachings of Islam, in a way summarizing some of the values. He talks about the sanctity of human life, Muslims, especially Muslims, their life and dignity and property. He talks about the importance of prohibition of interest and usury, riba. He puts an end to tribal strife of taking revenge generation after generations. And he also, said that Shaitan has lost hope in being worshipped in this land of Hijaz, but he will misguide you in minor issues. Then he talks about the women's rights and about the brotherhood of the Muslims in general, equality of Muslims, and then also giving importance to the laws of inheritance, and of course the issue of succession of Amir al-Mu'mineen as his Khalifa and Wasi, as an imam and the wali of the mu'mineen. This was the main theme of this khutba. When it came to the issue of the sanctity of human life, especially talking about Muslims, addressing the mu'mineen and the muslimin there, he says, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّ دِمَاءُكُمْ وَعَرَاضُكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ حَرَامٌ إِلَىٰ أَن تَلْقُوا رَبُّكُمْ. He says, oh people, your blood, in the sense your life and your honor, is sanct. It is, haram for you to violate the sanctity of it. إِلَىٰ أَن تَلْقُوا رَبُّكُمْ, until you meet your Lord. كَحُرُمَةِ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا فِي بَلَدِكُمْ هَذَا عَلَىٰ هَلْ بَلَّغْتَ اللَّهُمَّ أَشْهُدْ. He makes sure that he says to them that, I can wait the message, and, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you be witness. You look at the Muslims, how far they have moved away from these basic teachings when we talked about the sanctity of life and honor and property of one another. Look at the situation, all the way from Pakistan and Afghanistan to Iraq and Syria, and go to Yemen. And ask the question, who is killing whom? Of course, we have this habit all the time to say, oh, it's behind the scene is CIA and Mossad and this and that. Well, why we have gone to that level that we are being used as puppets? In reality, it's the Muslims there killing one another. In talking about this situation of Pakistan, where it had become, till just, a few years ago, where killing of Muslims in masjid by Muslims became a very common thing, especially the Shia minorities, the way they were being targeted. And a young person, made a presentation in the parliament there. And this person said something very interesting. He says, even the malaika are confused. Because they see the person who is, pulling the trigger says, Allahu Akbar. And the person who is dying says, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. So even the malaika are confused, what's going on? And this is where we have to realize how far Muslims have gone from the teachings of the Prophet of Islam. The Prophet also talks about, the unity of Muslims, irrespective of the color or race. But he says, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّ رَبُّكُمْ وَاحِدٌ وَإِنَّ أَبَاكُمْ وَاحِدٌ. That, O people, your Lord is one Lord, and your Father is one. كُلُّكُمْ لِآدَمٍ. All of you go back to Adam. وَآدَمٍ مِّن تُرَابٍ. And Adam was created from the earth. إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ إِنْ دَاللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. He goes to this ayat from Surah Al-Hujurat, that the most honorable among you is the one who is most righteous. وَلَيْسَ لِعَرَبِيٍ عَلَىٰ عَجَمِيٍ فَضْلٌ إِلَّا بِالتَّقْوَىٰ. No Arab has a preference over non-Arab except on the basis of taqwa and righteousness. And that is where he says, again, have I conveyed the message? And then he says, فَلِيُبَلِّغُ الشَّاهِدَ الْغَائِبِ. Those who are present here, you have to convey this message to those who are absent. Talking about the rights of the women, just two or three items here. He says, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّ لِنِسَائِكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ حَقًّا وَلَكُمْ عَلَيْهِنَّ حَقًّا. You see, it's important. He doesn't talk about men's right here. He talks about, singles out the women's right. He says, remember, people, your women have a right on you just as you have a right on them. So the main thing is that the haq and rights are mutual. It's not only one-sided. And the other side of the coin is always, when you look at a right, there is duties on the other side. And the duties also are, relevant to both genders there. And then at the end he says, أَخَسْتُمُوهُنَّ بِأَمَانَةِ اللَّهِ. You have taken your wives as an amanat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keep that in mind. And you have made them halal for yourself based on the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ فِي النِّسَاءِ. Therefore, fear displeasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding women. And then he says also, remember her in the wasiyyah, the one-third that you make for your will. This is in addition to whatever rights Allah has given to her. And so let us remember some of these elements from the sermon of the Prophet in Ghadir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us loyal to his teachings, inshallah. Inna ahsan al-hadith kitabullah al-aziz, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wal asr inna al-insana lafi khusr illa al-lazina amanu wa amilu al-salihat wa tawasaw bil-haqq wa tawasaw bil-sabr. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي لا إله إلا هو الحليم الكريم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب وهو الغفور الرحيم ونشهد أن لا إله إلا هو العتوف للعباد بجوده والعواد على المظلمين بحلمه ونشهد أن محمدا نبيه وحبيبه سيد المرسلين والشفيع المذنبين ورحمة للعالمين صلى الله عليه وآله الضعين على سبيل الله بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة قادة الأمم وأولياء النعمة ومعدن الرحمة أوصيكم عباد الله بالتوبة عما سلف من ذنوبكم. Of course, Ghadir, the main purpose of Ghadir was the Vilayat of Ali ibn Abi Talib. And the first famous words that he uttered at that time, where he says, "Man kuntu mawlahu fa hadha aliyun mawla." Now, as I said it many times, you know, no learned Sunni scholar would ever deny the event or these words that the Prophet uttered in Ghadir. But then they say, well, you know, we differ with one another on the issue of the meaning of the word Mawla. And sometimes the question is put forward. They say, why didn't the Prophet use a very clear term? Why didn't he say, you know, Khalifa? Well, if you look at the versions that we have, it has been explained in all different ways. Even the poet from Medina by the name of Hassan bin Thabit al-Ansari, who was there, and he was a poet. So he's not only an Arab, he's an Arab who knows the language. He's an Arab who is able to compose poetry, actually about many different events which took place in the life of the Prophet. And even on the day of Ghadir, he came to the Prophet and he said, do you allow me to recite some lines of poetry about this event? And there he says very clearly that, you know, a time came where the Prophet asked the people that Allah is your Mawla, and I am your Mawla. Do you accept it? And when they said yes, then he says that, فَقَالَ لَهُمْ يَا عَلِي فَقَالَ لَهُ يَا عَلِي. Then the Prophet said to Ali, stand up. فَعِنِّي جَعَلْتُكَ بَعْدِي إِمَامًا وَهَادِيًا. These are his words in poetry. That, O Ali, I have appointed you as a Hadi and an Imam. So Hassan bin Thabit, an Arab, a poet, took these words as Mawla in the meaning of Hadi and Imam. What else do you want? You're sitting there 1400 years back and saying, well, you know, let us look at the dictionary. There are seven meanings of Mawla. And then you try to find the one which will suit your aqidah. No, look at what the people understood at that time. When Umar comes and congratulates and says, Asbahta Mawlai wa Mawla al-Mu'mineen wa Mu'mina, kull Mu'minin wa Mu'mina. You have become a Mawla. Becoming a Mawla in what sense there? Not friend. And so, anyway, that's another discussion. I just digress from my, you know, notes here. I wanted to share with you, you know, when people say, well, why didn't the Prophet use the term Khalifa? If that is the issue, if we present to you a hadith where the Prophet uses the word Khalifa for Ali, would you accept it then? Or is it just, you know, argument after arguments? There is a very famous Sunni scholar of hadith who was actually contemporary of Muhammad bin Ismail al-Bukhari, the compiler of Sahih Bukhari. They lived at the same time. You know, Bukhari died in 256 after Hijrah, and this other alim by the name of Ibn Abi Asim died in 286. They lived almost at the same time, but Asim was there longer than Bukhari. And he has a book, Kitab al-Sunnah. In that book, he has a narration where he quotes his chain of narration going all the way to Abdullah ibn Abbas, a very prominent companion. And there he says, قَالَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ that the Prophet of Islam said to Ali, أَنْتَ مِنِّي بِمَنْزَلَةِ هَارُونَ مِنْ مُوسَى إِلَّا أَنَّكَ لَسْتَ نَبِيًّا. The Prophet is saying to Ali, you are to me at the same station and level or status as Harun was to Musa, except that you are not a prophet. إِنَّهُ لَا يَنْبَغِي أَنْ عَضْحَبُ إِلَّا وَأَنْتَ خَلِيفَتِي فِي كُلِّ مُؤْمِنٍ مِّنْ بَعْدِي. He says, it is necessary that I go. Means I'm going to die one day. It is necessary that I go while you will be my successor. وَأَنْتَ خَلِيفَتِي. You will be my Khalifa fi kulli mu'min min ba'di, for every believer after me. You're looking for clear words? Any more clear words than those? No. These days, you know, some of our young people have newly learned ilm hadith, and they say, well, you know, all these hadith, Maulanas and scholars and speakers narrate, these are all fabrications and from ghulat. So easy to say dha'if and use the term ghali. Well, this is not from the Shia sources anyway. This is from Sunni source. And if you want to know the authenticity of this hadith, a very prominent Salafi scholar, Wahhabi scholar of our century, a scholar of hadith by the name of Sheikh Muhammad Nasiruddin al-Albani, he died in 1999, originally from Albanian background, but raised in Syria. And he became a very prominent scholar in the science of hadith among the Wahhabi, the Salafis. And he actually published this book of Kitab al-Sunnah of Ibn Abi Asim with annotations by himself as a scholar of hadith. About every hadith he will say, this is right or wrong, za'if or sahih, you know. And so in that, And annotations that he has on this Kitab al-Sunnah of Ibn Abi Asim, Sheikh Albani makes the comment. He says, إسناده حسن ورجاله ثقات رجال الشيخين. He says the chain of narration is good of this hadith, and its narrators are trustworthy among the narrators of the two sheikh, Bukhari and Muslim. So you have a hadith from the Sunni sources, verified by most prominent Salafi scholar of hadith in this century, where the Prophet says that Ali is my Khalifa for every mu'min min ba'di, after me. Salawat Quran Akbar. You know, they were very cleverly say, well, yes, we believe he's a Khalifa, but he's a fourth one. That would be the response. When you say, well, the Prophet said, you know, Ali will be my Khalifa after me. Well, Rasulullah didn't say Ali would be Khalifa after the three Khulafa. Min ba'di, after me. What does that mean? He didn't say after 25 years. After I die, when he says min ba'di, this is after me, immediately after me. And that is why we say, you know, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah, Aliyun Waliullah, wa khalifatuhu bila fasl. Salawat. اللهم صل على سيد المرسلين وشفيع المذنبين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وعلى إمام المتقين وأمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب صلوات الله عليه وعلى سيدة شباب أهل الجنة الحسن المجتبى والحسين الشهيد بكربلاء عليهم الصلاة والسلام. اللهم صل على سيدة النساء العالمين سيدتنا فاطمة بنت رسول الله صلوات الله عليها اللهم صل على أئمة المسلمين علي بن حسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي عليهم الصلاة والسلام اللهم صل على مولانا الحجة بن الحسن صاحب العصر والزمان محيا أصار البدء والطغيان هذه بأمنية الشرك والنفاق حاسد فر البغ والشقاق صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آباء الكرام من اتصلت الليالي والأيام اللهم عجل فرج وصح المخرج واكحل ناظرنا بنظرة منا إليه واجعلنا من المستشهدين بين يديه اللهم اجعلنا ممن يذكر فتنفعه الذكرى إن الله يعمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اللهم صل على